that project move forward is key for those communities to be able to access sustainable and reliable water.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Los Andes Copper Chairman Eduardo Covarrubias. Eduardo, very good to speak with you again. Desala Petorca, which you signed a letter of intent with back in 2022, has announced a strategic alliance and investment from Chilean power company Colbún. How does that impact Los Andes?
Well, hi, Stephen. Thanks for having me back. Yes, Desala is a water desalination project. It's located off the coast on the Petorca Valley, which is immediately north of us. And for us, this joint venture and investment is a very important milestone or step forward in our project. As a bit of a background, the Desala project is going to be supplying water on a multi-client basis to several mining companies, agriculture producers, and communities, very importantly, up the Petorca Valley. That valley is one of the most heavily hit areas of the country by the decades-long droughts. So having that project move forward is key for those communities to be able to access sustainable and reliable water. In our case, we signed the LOI with them a couple of years ago. And what that does is, on our end, it gives us sustainable desalinated water, but also it extends the benefits of availability of water to some of the communities of Putaendo. And we believe that's a major component of our community strategy and how mining can benefit the communities everywhere. And so that's for us is key. I'd say the other thing is just as a note. I mean, Colbún, which is their new partner, may not be a name that's a household name in the Northern Hemisphere, if you will, but it is the second largest power generation company and part of a very large economic group. For us, it's very important that Desala has strong sponsors. They also have Icafal, which is one of the larger construction companies as well. So these are terrific partners for Desala and a good endorsement for a project that's going to be moving forward. Also, it's worth mentioning that Vizcachitas is going to be the anchor client of that project. So we are a very key component of the feasibility of that whole desalination project.
Eduardo, you've also announced that you've streamlined the royalty for the Vizcachitas project with Franco-Nevada Corporation. Why have you done this?
Yes, no, that's another element. I mean, sort of in anticipation for when Vizcachitas comes into production. The Franco-Nevada agreement had certain elements that needed to be streamlined, which made it easier to operate once production begins. So we did all that. I mean, from an economic standpoint and from a general standpoint, there's really no change at all in the royalty itself. But by streamlining the execution or the operation of that royalty, it makes it easier for Franco Nevada and the company to work this forward afterwards. And in the process, we got $1,020,000 of interest fee prepayment, which is always nice as it further strengthens our balance sheet.
Apart from these developments, could you give us a recap of what's been happening over the last year, Eduardo?
Absolutely. I think our efforts have been centered on a couple of areas. On the first of all, on the community area, I think that's key. We've been continuing to work with the team. Santiago and the team in Chile have done a terrific job in consolidating the presence there, the building, the trust and the relationships that are key for advancing a project. So they've been working on that front and also doing quite a bit of the pre-baseline work for the environmental approval packages. So that's one area we've been working on quite intensely. We've been doing some geophysics and magnetics works on the property itself. And that has to do with further defining or looking at the areas of expansion, immediate expansion of the Vizcachitas deposit itself. And also because we have a very large footprint in the area, we've done some more exploratory type of work in the valley itself, up and down the valley.
And what else can investors expect over the coming months then?
Well, we're looking to quite a few pretty exciting news. In addition to the community side, as I was mentioning, that work's going to continue to be done. We need to do that work also to the standards of what a major mining company would expect to see. That requires discipline and intensity of certain aspects, so that work is actually conducive to a quicker permitting and then path to production. And we expect to have some exciting news along those lines. Also, as I mentioned earlier, as we have the results of all this geophysics work and exploration work finalized, we'll definitely publish that and show some of the results that we believe are very exciting. And we'll follow up with some additional work along those lines.
I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Eduardo, thank you very much for the update today.
Stephen, thank you very much, and hope to see you in the near future. Thanks.
Very welcome, Los Andes Copper Chairman Eduardo Covarrubias.